Everything is so basic, so limited. I hope it's not the Omnitool falling apart. Okay, we need to find you a power suit. You know, so we can go into the abyss without ending up like a recycled can of soda?
You think we'll find one that fits me? I mean, I'm kind of in a suit already.
That's been bothering me too. You know how you were transferred from Vancouver?
Toronto.
From then to now.
How could I forget?
Okay, so we do it again.
You want to send me to the future?
No, you idiot. I want to transfer your mind into a new body.
What?
Look, we already know it can be done. We don't need to make it a big deal.
It is a big deal, Kath. It's a huge fucking deal. There's got to be something else that can take us down there.
But Dunbat at Theta was the only vessel that could take that pressure, and you saw what happened.
Then think of something else.
Simon, please. You don't have to switch this instant. Just play along for now. If we find something else, then great. If not...
I'm not promising anything.
Thank you, Simon. Have a look around the room. This is where they would keep the power suits, if there are any left.
Thank you.
you waiting for? Find a power suit and let's get on with this.
Oh, God. Nice. I found one of the power suits. There's a dead woman inside. At least I think it's a woman. Just like the body we found in the annex. She's missing her head.
Gross. This could work in our favor, though. Look for a terminal nearby, see if you can boot it up.
Not exactly grade A material.
Don't write it off just yet. Remember what we found out at Theta. The suit you are wearing is basically just a Cortex chip working a few pints of structure gel, powered by the on-suit battery pack.
And a dead colleague, Imogen Reed.
Exactly. If you think about it, we're actually incredibly lucky. We found a suit with an already dead body inside.
I guess you're right. What about the wow? What makes you think it'll play along?
It's not magic, it's algorithms. A set pattern. The WoW won't be able to deny us, even if it was capable of wanting to.
I'm still not crazy about this plan. It feels wrong.
Please, Simon, I can't give up on the Ark. I need this to work.
So we need a Cortex chip, structure gel, and a battery pack. That's one hell of a shopping list.
Thanks. I'll just hang around here if that's okay.
I'll be back.
We need to get a Cortex chip, a battery pack, and some structure gel. Don't forget, we need a Cortex chip, structure gel, and a power pack to get the suit ready. Thank you.
Thank you. Sam read about protein solubilization. Do you think we could break the aggregate and structure gel without flattening the configuration?
Jesus, that was a mouthful. You've been listening to Cameron, that's for sure. What do you want, Raleigh?
Can you blame me for trying to figure this out? I've been having the dreams too, you know. I don't know what to believe.
Oh, I know. Everything from the sudden signal amplification in black boxes to having a comatose Dr. Ross locked up in the glass jar. We've all been going a bit nuts.
Tell me about it. Feels like my head's about to explode. Hypothetically speaking, could we stop the WoW from mutating?
It doesn't work like that.
Even if there was a site alpha?
Hypothetically speaking, I guess we could try. Rally, are you recording this?
Sorry. I just... Sorry.
Johan Ross was found dead on the climber this morning. The ARC team went down a couple of days ago, but I see no reason to suspect them playing a part in his death. The climber can't be operated from the abyss, so there was a scheduled retrieval. The climber returned with only the lifeless body of Alpha member Johan Ross. No traces of the ARC team. Cameron, Eames, Lansky, all studying the body inside containment. Follow up with whatever they find. Delenda Est. The WoW has been getting more aggressive, pushing all systems to their limits. Ironically, the dead Dr. Johan Ross would be the perfect person to ask why the WoW is making such a big buzz about his passing. After all, the WoW isn't supposed to want anything, and definitely not to mourn people. The system overload affects the staff considerably. Headaches, loss of sleep, unwarranted stress. And it seems to be getting worse. I could use some advice if you can get through. Delenda Est. Things are out of hand. The staff looks like they're about to explode. Every other person walks around with nosebleeds, and the rest keep wiping stains of blood from their eyes to keep them from overflowing. That's to do with the WoW trying to free Ross somehow, for sure. At this point, I wouldn't be surprised if the body just got up and left. Rally Herber, our dispatcher, has been snooping around asking questions she shouldn't. She says she's going down into the abyss to find Alpha. I can't bring myself to stop her.
Strasky, are you there?
I hear you, Herbie. What's up?
Just wanted to check in. I have to go do something. I might not be around for a few days, okay?
Rally Herbert leaving the listening post? Must be important.
It is, Strask. It is.
Okay, then. Stay safe.
Omicron, can you hear us?
Loud and clear. Everyone all right?
We will be as soon as we make friends with the power suits.
I'm sure you'll get used to it.
Look at that. Just wanted to check in before we pass the last working Lumar probe. Guys, any last words to Omicron?
Don't forget to pick us up.
You heard that, right?
Don't worry, we won't forget.
All right. Heading into radio silence.
Good luck, guys.
Tau, please respond. This is Rally Herber calling from Omicron. Please respond, Tau.
Unable to connect. Lumar relay out of range.
Yeah, I get it.
Unable to connect. Lumar relay out of range. Unable to connect. Lumar relay out of range.
Oh. Now.